Hey, it actually doesn't matter if you're a Republican or a Democrat or anywhere in between, not when it comes to solar energy. It simply isn't a partisan issue. And that's what many Americans and government leaders are getting wrong. It's likely because so many of us still think that people who go solar must look like this or this. My point is, you don't have to look a certain way or think a certain way to benefit from going solar, or at least support the idea of it. Would you like to spend less money on electricity? How about having access to energy when you need it, no matter what's going on in the world? Those things sound pretty good, don't they? While solar energy helps your household, it also has a much bigger role to play. It can help America truly reach energy independence. And if I don't have you convinced by the end of this episode of Plugged In, well, you can sound off in the comments. Now today we're talking about why solar isn't a partisan issue, or at least why it shouldn't be. Why am I talking about this now? Well, aside from doing my part to minimize solar stereotypes, it's relevant.
Because on his first day in office, newly elected President Donald Trump created an executive order that put a 90-day freeze on funding for the Inflation Reduction Act.
Now, if you're not a policy buff, the Inflation Reduction Act, or IRA, provides various tax credits and rebates for homeowners who make clean energy upgrades, like solar panels, heat pumps, and electric vehicles, so that you and I have more of a shot at actually affording these things without having to sacrifice our dinners. Plus, the IRA incentivizes American businesses to make parts for clean technology, which creates jobs and boosts our economy.
Do you have any jobs available?
And we'll dive more into the perks of the IRA later, but first, I want to make one thing abundantly clear. While the IRA was created under the Biden presidency, the origins of these federal solar incentives are pretty bipartisan. Let's take a quick trip through time.
Are you telling me that you built a time machine?
Now, back in 2005, Republican President George W. Bush signed the Energy Policy Act into law, which created the Solar Investment Tax Credit, or ITC. Now, this incentive means that home and business owners buying solar or energy storage systems would get a tax credit worth 30% of the system, capped at $2,000. Now, it was only set to last a couple of years, but the Obama administration extended the ITC, removed that $2,000 cap, which really sweetened the deal. The program actually became so popular, it was renewed multiple times, including in 2020 under the Trump administration. Fast forward 2 years, this beloved tax credit extended once again under the Biden administration, bundled into this bigger clean energy spending act that we now have, the IRA. So there you have it, Republicans and Democrats all working together to create or maintain this federal solar incentive. But enough about the politicians, how are the rest of us feeling? Well, a 2024 study found that nearly 90% of Americans are in favor of government programs to help homeowners go solar. That includes 78% of 2020 voters for President Donald Trump. Plus, a 2019 poll found that 92% of Americans want the U.S. to expand solar power, including 86% of Republicans and 96% of Democrats surveyed. This data actually makes my job a lot easier because it means that most of you, no matter your political beliefs, do agree with me that solar is a good thing and that these federal incentives should stay. So I guess my work here is done.
I'm not buying it.
All right. What if I told you that the IRA was really good for jobs? We're talking
really, really, really ridiculously good.
Check this out. Some research groups looked into clean energy projects tied to the IRA and found that they would create over 621,000 direct and indirect new jobs over the next 5 years. That's a lot of jobs relying on that policy, and 80% of those manufacturing investments are in Republican-led districts. That hasn't gone unnoticed. In fact, 18 House Republicans wrote a letter in support of the IRA back in August. And sure, they called the bill deeply flawed, but they urged against a full repeal, saying, quote, "Energy tax credits have spurred innovation, incentivized investment, and created good jobs in parts of the country." Enough about clean energy jobs, let's talk about something that we can all relate to. Solar is good for your wallet.
Show me the money!
Now, the cost of going solar in America has dropped significantly in recent years, while the price of electricity has hit all-time highs. Energy Sage data shows that the average homeowner pays off their solar panels in roughly 7 years, and after that, you'd be paying little to nothing for electricity for at least the next 2 decades, which turns into about $60,000 in energy savings.
Money.
However, these savings do include current financial incentives like those that are in the IRA. So what happens if you don't go solar? Well, let's say your current monthly electric bill is $50. You'd spend about $27,600 on electricity over the next 30 years. If your bill is $150, that's roughly $83,000 in electricity expenses, and a $250 bill, you'd be shelling out over $138,000 to your utility.
If you're gonna spew,
spew into this?
But saving money brings us a lot of freedom, which actually brings me to my next pitch. Solar brings energy independence. Let's look at this at a small scale first.
I really wanted to get off the grid as much as I could.
This is Alan. He installed solar panels on his Massachusetts home, and now he generates his own electricity to use during the day. He still does have to rely on the grid at night, or other times when the sun isn't shining, but luckily for Alan, Massachusetts has a great incentive program that allows him to earn energy credits for the electricity that his panels produce, which he can then use to net out his bills. The result? Alan sees $3,500 in annual energy savings.
I made it through the year, produced almost exactly what I consumed, and now I think that I'll be able to get through the next year with no electricity bills at all.
Now, what would happen if we added battery storage to that solar system? Let's take a look. During the day, your solar panels would power up your home devices, and any extra energy would go to your battery. Then at night, you pull energy from your battery, so you don't have to take any electricity from your utility. Having a solar plus storage setup also means that you'd still have electricity if there were a power outage or a zombie apocalypse. Just ask the preppers, they love solar.
When it comes to emergency preparedness and prepping for a grid down event, I think solar power is going to be your ticket.
Now, showing you how solar provides independence for a single home is just an example of how adding large-scale renewables across America would help us become energy independent as a country. Now, President Trump and other Republicans have mentioned an alternative.
Drill, baby, drill.
And even if we ignore all the environmental implications of that plan, the reality is that fossil fuels would run out eventually. And on the other hand, if the wind stops blowing, the water stops flowing, and the sun disappears, well, we'd have a lot bigger problems than just where we get our electricity.
That's not good.
Energy expert Jacob Ahrens-Volwit said it best in a recent article that the term American energy independence is... Actually, why am I telling you this? Let's just ask him.
So my name is Jacob Ahrens-Volwit. I'm the Strategic Communications Manager at Clean Wisconsin.
All right, so you said in your article that the term American energy independence needs to evolve, and it's too often used to justify an unsustainable reliance on fossil fuels. Can you elaborate more on your opinion on that?
I think that the only way that we can achieve energy independence is through clean energy. I think as long as we are dependent on fossil fuels for our energy, I don't think that we have true energy independence. By generating clean energy locally, we're shielding ourselves against volatile global markets. We're providing all of the downstream benefits of the manufacturing of the clean energy products, of the jobs.
Now, even if we did expand drilling efforts in Alaska, Florida, Georgia, and South Carolina, the benefits wouldn't extend to all states evenly. Most states would probably still be hit with some type of import tax. And on the other hand, renewable energy alternatives like solar, wind, hydropower, they're available across a lot more states, like Wisconsin.
So Wisconsin doesn't have any coal. We don't extract natural gas here in the state. We pay $14 billion every single year to bring in fossil fuel resources. And the Inflation Reduction Act is one pathway that will help allow Wisconsin and other states like Wisconsin to keep that money in the state.
Now, Wisconsin isn't the only state that has seen these types of benefits or has taken advantage of the IRA incentives to install more renewable energy. Actually, I want to show you something. This map shows you the top 10 states that installed the most solar in 2023, the first full year the IRA was in effect. And of these 10 states, 7 voted red in the 2024 election. This further underlines my point that renewable energy is not politically motivated. Right, Jacob?
When I think about solar, I think about saving money, creating jobs, and really increasing the reliability of the energy that we use. People from all different walks of life, all across the political spectrum, are installing solar. They all have their own reasons, and we need to be supporting policies that help it work for more people.
As Jacob said, it's about if solar works for you, and it might not. Your home might not get enough solar, or maybe you live in an apartment. Hopefully by now you know that the point we're trying to make is not that you need to run out and buy solar panels. That's great if you can, but it's more important that you support solar expansion for the sake of jobs and the economy and helping America rely more on our own clean energy instead of volatile global markets. Things that should matter to you, no matter who you vote for. Well, that's all I've got for today. Big shout out to Jacob for helping me get the point across. And if you have any questions or another topic you want us to dive into, drop a comment below and stay plugged in.